Hello world, this is Abdul from Pythonist.
If list and tuples both use the same underlying data structure, which is arrays, what are the differences between the two? By summarizing, the main differences are the following. The number one is, lists are dynamic arrays. They are mutable and allow for resizing, which means changing the number of elements that are held. While tuples are static arrays, they are immutable and the data within them cannot be changed once they have been created. Tuples are cached by the pointer runtime, which means that we don't need to talk to the kernel to reserve memory every time we want to use one. While lists are not cached by the pointer runtimes due to the dynamic nature. These differences outline the philosophical difference between the two. Tuples are for describing multiple properties of one unchanging thing, and lists can be used to store collections of data about completely disparate objects. For example, the parts of a telephone number are perfect for a tuple. They wouldn't change, and if they do, they represent a new object or a different phone number. Similarly, the coefficients of a polynomial fit a tuple, since different coefficients represent a different polynomial. On the other hand, the names of the people currently watching this video are better suited for a list. The data is constantly changing both in content and in size, but it's still always representing the same idea. It is important to note that both lists and tuples can take mixed types. This can, as we will discuss in the upcoming videos, introduce quite some overhead and reduce some potential optimizations. These overheads can be removed if we force all of our data to be of the same type. In our upcoming videos, we will talk about reducing both the memory usage and the computational overhead by using NumPy library. In addition, other packages like BuildList and Array can also reduce these overheads for other non-numerical situations. This alludes to a major point in performant programming that we will touch in our later videos. Generic code will be much slower than the code specifically designed to solve a particular problem. The immutability of a tuple as opposed to a list, which can be resized and changed, makes it a very lightweight data structure. This means that there isn't much overhead in memory when sorting them, and the operations with them are quite straightforward. With lists, as we will learn more in details, the immutability comes at the price of extra memory needed to store them and extra computation needed when using them. So let's take a look at the list as the dynamic arrays, and let's try to write some code. Once we create a list, we are free to change its content as needed. This is the dynamic nature of list. So I have defined the list named as numbers with a bunch of different elements. And if we want to change the value of the element at the third position, we will simply first access that particular element using its index, which is 2. So I will call numbers into 2 equal to, and I will assign the new updated value. And once again, if we print that list, you can see that here, that particular element has been changed. As I described earlier, this operation is done in big O of 1. Because we can find the data stored at the second position immediately. In addition, we can append new data to a list and grow its size. So let's first take a look at the size of the numbers list. It's 6. So I will just try to append a new element to the list by using the append method of list. So I will call numbers.append and then pass a new element, let's say 32. And you can see that actually, if once again we will check the size of that particular list, it will be 7. This is possible because dynamic arrays support a resize operation that increases the capacity of the array. When a list of size n is first appended to, Python must create a new list that is big enough to hold the original n elements in addition to the extra one that is being appended. However, instead of allocating n plus 1 items, m items are actually allocated, where m is definitely greater than n, then the data from the old list is copied to the new list and the old list is destroyed. This philosophy is that one append is probably the beginning of many appends, and by requesting extra space, we can reduce the number of time this allocation must happen, and thus the total number of memory copies that are necessary. This is quite important, since memory copies can be quite expensive, especially when list sizes start growing. But this extra allocation happens on the first append only. When a list is directly created, as in the preceding example we will take a look, only the number of elements needed is allocated. So let's elaborate this statement in a detailed way. So for example, we have a list with two elements, 1 and 2. And now we want to append a new element as 3. So what do we have to do then? The system will copy both of two elements into a new list, but providing it an extra room for any future appends. So the size of the new list will be the 4 instead of 3, because we have appended only one element. The needed number of elements is 3, but we got 4. So in the future, when we will need to append a new element into the list, we can directly append at it instead of copying all the elements to the new list. But now, at this stage, we have 4 elements and the list of the size 4. So now at this time, once again, if we want to append a new element, for example 5, so once again, the previous operation will be repeated. So this is how the dynamic nature of lists are working onto our system and adding much more overhead to the system memory and the computation execution. So I think that's enough elaboration about the dynamic natures of lists. So let's take a look at the tuples as static arrays. Tuples are fixed and immutable. This means that once a tuple is created, unlike a list, it cannot be modified or resized. So for example, if I have a tuple with the numbers 1, 2, 3, and 4, and if I try to add a number 5 into this tuple, so we will get that item assignment operation doesn't support it error. However, although they don't support resizing, we can concatenate two tuples together and form a new tuple. This operation is similar to resize operation on list, but we don't allocate any extra space for the resulting tuple. So we have a tuple t, so let me create a new tuple t1 with the different elements. That's it. And we can simply concatenate both of the tuples t plus t1. And here's the new tuple which has been generated by the concatenation of these two existing tuples. If we consider this to be comparable to the append operation on the list, we see that it performs in big O of n as opposed to the big O of 1 speed of list. This is because the allocate or the copy operations must happen each time we add something new to the tuple, as opposed to the only whenever extra bedrooms run out for list. As a result of this, there is no in-place append-like operation. Addition of two tuples always returns a new tuple that is in a new location in memory. Not sorting the extra headroom for resizing has the advantages of using fewer resources. Furthermore, if we create a list without append, it will still be larger in memory than a tuple with the same data. This is because lists have to keep track of more information about their current state in order to efficiently resize. While this extra information is quite small, the equivalent of one extra element, it can add up of several millions lists are in use. Another benefit of the static nature of tuples is something Python does in the background: resource caching. Python is garbage collected, which means when a variable isn't used anymore, Python frees the memory used by that variable, giving it back to the operating system for use in other application or for other variables. For tuples of sizes 1 to 20, however, when they are no longer in use, the space isn't immediately given back to the system, but rather saved for future use. This means that when a new tuple of that size is needed in the future, we don't need to communicate with the operating system to find a region in the memory to put the data, since we have a reserve of the free memory already. While this may seem like a small benefit, it is one of the fantastic things about tuples. They can be created easily and quickly since they can avoid communication with the operating system, which can cost your program quite a bit of time. So in conclusion, lists and tuples are fast and low overhead objects to use when your data already has an intrinsic ordering in it. This intrinsic ordering allows you to sidestep the search problem in these structures. If the ordering is known beforehand, then lookups are big O of 1, avoiding an expensive big O of n linear search. While list can be resized, you must take care to properly understand how much over-allocation is happening to ensure that the dataset can still fit in memory. On the other hand, tuples can be created quickly and without the added overhead of list at the cost of not being modifiable. In our later videos, we will discuss how to pre-allocate lists in order to alleviate some of the burden regarding frequent appends to Python lists and look at some of other optimizations that can help to manage these problems.